Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our current affair MCQ series, in which what we do, we daily discuss your MCQs from current affair perspective. So today is 22 October, so let's see what are the questions of today. So the first question is, consider the following statement. First, Mahatma Gandhi was convinced that armed struggle was the only way to achieve independence for India. Under him, Azad Hind Provisional Government, the Indians living abroad had been united. Second statement is, Azad Hind Government had male full female contingent under Captain Lakshmi. So we have to choose that which of the above statements are correct. So friends, obviously first statement is straightforward wrong, because you know that Mahatma Gandhi was strictly non-violent in his approach for India's struggle for independence, as well as in his entire life cycle he propounded the message of non-violence. So first statement is clearly wrong. So second is correct, Azad Hind government had made a full female contingent under Captain Lakshmi. So 21st October 2019 was celebrated as the 76th anniversary of the formation of Azad Hind government. So about Azad Hind government is that Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose had announced the establishment of provisional government of Azad Hind in occupied Singapore in 1943. So please note this is very important. Where it was formed in Singapore. So it was formed, the year is also important, in 1943, and it was formed by Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. So on 21st October this was formed. So also it was also known as Arzi Hukumat-e-Azad Hind. It was supported by the Axis power of Imperial Japan, Nazi Germany, and the Italian Social Republic and their allies. So with this, Bose had launched a struggle to free India from British rule under the banner of provisional government in exile during the later part of the Second World War. So why was it set up? It was basically to start the armed struggle, because Subhash Chandra Bose was convinced that armed struggle was the only way to achieve independence for India. So under his provisional government, so Indians living abroad had been united. So Indian National Army drew ex-prisoners and thousands of civilian volunteers from the Indian expatriate population in Malaya, that is Malay Peninsula and Burma, now Myanmar. So the formation was on October 21, 1943. So it was announced by Subhash Chandra Bose on the battlefield of Singapore, which was once the bulwark of British Empire. So under the provisional government, Bose was the head of the state and the prime minister and the minister for war and foreign affairs. So please note this is very important. So Subhash Chandra Bose was the head of the state, as well as prime minister, as well as minister for war and foreign affairs. So Captain Lakshmi headed the women's organization, and then there was S.A. Iyer who headed the publicity and propaganda wing, and then Ras Bihari Bose was designated as the supreme advisor. So the provisional government was also formed in Japanese occupied Andaman and Nicobar Islands. The islands were reoccupied by the British in 1945. So how it came to an end, because Bose's death was seen as the end to the Azad Hind movement. The Second World War also ended in 1945 with the defeat of the Axis power. So this was about your first question. Let's move on to the second question. Before moving on to the second question, one important thing which came to my mind is that, friends, some students, or I don't know, some people, either they are jealous or either they don't want the service to continue. They keep on commenting on the way of my speaking, the accent I use, and then the way I speak English. So a serious aspirant would certainly be not interested in such things. So I appeal to all such stupid people to stay away from this channel, because they are not needed. And if they think that they can demotivate us, or they can keep us, they will involve us in such petty issues, then we are not such people. And today I am saying this, I will not repeat this again. And simply what I will do, I will remove the comments. And earlier also I have done the same by removing the comments of these stupids. And please be serious and be focused upon your preparation. You are not here for your life. You are preparing for your exam, and you have a very limited time. And keep in mind that you have to crack this exam. So if you will get involved in politics of all these things, then certainly it will be of no avail. So let's move on to the second question. Second is, consider the following statements. First, the State Information Commissioner is removed by the governor on the ground of proved misbehavior or incapacity. Second is the tenure of the State Information Commissioner is for the maximum period of 6 years. So which of the above statements are correct? So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you, friends, let me recall it, the State Information. Yeah, State Information Commissioner is removed by the governor. So tenure is not now about 6 years. It has been reduced to 3 years, in fact, by the recent amendment to the RTA Act. So the answer would be A, one only. So more detail you can get in the book of Indian Polity by Lakshmikant, and sources from the Hindu. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to anthrax disease. First, anthrax disease is a zoonotic disease caused by bacillus anthracis. Second is, there is no cure available for the disease as of now and lead to fatality of the affected persons. We have to choose that which of the above statements are correct. Let me tell you, friends, the first statement is correct. Yes, it is a zoonotic disease. So it is mostly seen in cattle, sheep and goat. And basically, it is not that there is no cure available for it. Cure is available for it. But sometimes the disease spreads so fatly that it becomes difficult for the antibiotic to treat it. So the answer is, solution is A, that is one only. So this is basically, this was seen in news because in Assam's Pobithora sanctuary, two buffaloes, that is Asiatic water buffaloes, had been killed by this anthrax disease. So it is a disease caused by Bacillus anthracis, that a germ that lives in soil. So it affects animals more often than people, such as cattle, sheep and goats. And people can get this disease from if they are in contact with infected animals, wool, meat or hides. So it can spread. It does not spread directly from one infected animal or person to another, but it is spread by spores. These spores can be transported by clothing or shoes. So symptoms and infection is basically respiratory infection is the first symptom. So it initially presents with cold or flu-like symptoms for several days, followed by pneumonia and severe and often fatal respiratory collapse. And then there is gastrointestinal infection that happens, due to which this extreme the difficulty is caused is extreme. So then sometimes vomiting is experienced, and that is also of blood, and severe diarrhea, acute inflammation of the intestinal tract, and loss of appetite is seen. And then this cutaneous anthrax, also known as Hyde Porter's disease. Please note this. This is also known as Hyde Porter's disease. So this is basically there is also a topic in your science NCERT. Perhaps it is of 8th or 9th class. I don't remember the class. But in that NCERT also of science, this disease has been talked about. So Hyde Porter's disease is the cutaneous on the skin manifestation of anthrax infection in humans. So treatment is basically a 60-day course of an antibiotic, but then this treatment is effective when started as soon as possible, because in some cases although some cases of anthrax respond to antibiotics, advanced inhalation anthrax may not. So by the later stages of the disease, the bacteria have often produced more toxins than drugs can eliminate. Then also it has been used in bioterrorism earlier by different agents and terrorist organizations. So it was also spread in US through a telegraph mail. It killed 5 people and made 22 sick. Now let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to International Monetary Fund. First, its function is to provide financial assistance to member countries with balance of payment problems. The IMF lends money to replenish international reserves, stabilize currencies and strengthen conditions for economic growth. Second is, all the members of the IMF have equal voting rights. So let me tell you, friends, that first statement is correct, but second is not correct. Voting rights are not not equal, but they are rather determined by the contribution of different economies to the fund. So the answer would be A, solution is A. So IMF is an international organization of 189 member countries. Objective is to foster global monetary cooperation, secure financial stability, and then facilitate international trade, promote high employment and sustainable economic growth, and also reduce poverty around the world. So functions are basically it provides financial assistance to such countries that are suffering from balance of payment problems, and then also it lends money to replenish international reserves, stabilize currencies and strengthen conditions for economic economic growth. So countries have to embark on structural adjustment policies that are monitored by the International Monetary Fund. So it also exercises surveillance. So it oversees the international monetary system and monitors the economic and financial policies of 189 member countries. So as part of this process, which takes place both at the global and the individual in the individual countries, the IMF highlights the possible risks to particular economy or to the possible risks to the stability and advises on needed policy adjustments. So capacity development also takes place. It provides technical assistance and training to central banks, finance ministries, tax authorities, and other economic institutions. So this helps countries raise public revenue, modernize banking systems, develop strong legal frameworks, improve governance, and enhance this reporting of macroeconomic and financial data. So it also helps the countries to make progress towards sustainable development goals. So IMF members, whether or not they're a member of United Nations, they can become the IMF member. So it is not necessary that they must be a member of UN. So, but then there is a condition for becoming the member of International Bank, for becoming a member of International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, because the IMF membership is required for that. So also then, the countries can become a member of the IMF in accordance with the IMF articles of agreement and terms prescribed by the Board of Governors. So there is a quota subscription. So in joining the IMF, each member country contributes a certain sum of money. So that is called a quota subscription. So which is based on country's wealth as well as economic formation. So quota formula is, there is a quota formula that is basically determined by weighted average of GDP. So weight of from 50% is given, and then openness weight of 30% is given, and then economic variability 15% weight is given, and international reserves 5% weight is given. So in this way, the GDP is measured. And then depending upon this calculating this quota, then ultimately quota subscription is allocated, which that country has to and that country has to contribute that certain sum of money that can be determined by this quota formula. So special drawing rights are also there. So SDRs is basically the IMF's unit of account and not a currency. So currency value of SDR is determined by it is unit of account. So note that it is unit of account and not a currency. So it is determined by the currency value, if you want to determine of SDR, it is determined by summing the values in US dollars based on market exchange rates of a SDR basket of currencies. So basically there is a basket of currencies in special drawing rights. So basket of currencies include US dollar, euro, Japanese yen, and then pound sterling, and then Chinese renminbi. So it was included in 2016. So basically currency value currency value of SDR is determined by the summing the values of some values in US dollars based on market exchange rates of a SDR market basket of currencies. So if you, for example, you have these five currencies, then this SDR value will be determined by summing the values in US dollars depending upon the market exchange rate. So for example, if there is a pound sterling and it has a market exchange rate of, suppose, $1 is equal to 3 pound sterling, then obviously 3 pound sterling will be calculated and it will be equivalent to $1. And in this way, different currencies they are calculated vis-a-vis the US dollar exchange rate based on market rates, and then the value that comes up, it is added, and then that value is allocated to the that is the currency value of SDR. So SDR currency value is calculated daily, so except on IMF holidays or whenever the IMF is closed for the business, and the valuation basket is reviewed and adjusted every 5 years. So it is not that just every 5 years the different currencies are considered, that whether they are to be included in SDRs or not. So quotas are denominated in SDRs. So if for example quota subscription will be calculated in terms of SDR. So country, if suppose India has 100 SDRs in it, so this will represent a claim to currency held by IMF member countries for which they may be exchanged. So then 100 SDRs meaning is that India can claim claim currency held by IMF member countries so for which they may be exchanged. So SDRs will be given, and then the required currency will be taken away by the country which it would be in need of. So members' voting power is related directly to their quotas, the amount of money they contribute to the institution. So IMF allows each member country to choose its own method of determining the exchange value of its money. The only requirements are that member no longer base the value of its currency on gold, which has proved to be too inflexible, and inform other members about precisely how it is determining the currency's value. Next is National Tiger Conservation Authority is established under A. Environmental Protection Act, B. Wildlife Protection Act, C. Indian Forest Act, D. National Biodiversity Act. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is B, that is Wildlife Protection Act. So NTCA is basically the conservation authority that was made under the Act of Wildlife Protection Act 1971. So it is a statutory body focused upon the tiger conservation in India, and also it is the implementing body of the Project Tiger. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, which article of Indian Constitution provides the fundamental right against self-incrimination? A. Article 21, B. Article 20, C. Article 19, D. Article 22. So friends, clear answer is B, that is Article 20. So this provides a person who is arrested, he cannot be forced to be a witness against him. So this is basically right against self-incrimination. So more detail you can check in Indian Polity by Lakshmikant, and the source of the question is The Hindu. So today I was in hurry, so I didn't include the explanation, but surely from next time I will include the explanations of these such questions also. Now let's move to the next question. Next is Bhashan Char Island seen in news is located in A. Bay of Bengal, B. Arabian Sea, C. South China Sea, D. None of the above. So friends, the answer is A. Bay of Bengal. So Bhashan Char Island is seen in news. It is basically relating to the resettlement of the Rohingyas. So this island is being developed by Bangladesh. So the Rohingyas who have been displaced, but due to that crisis, that was military crackdown that was launched on them in Rohingya state of Myanmar. So they will be settled there. So authorities concerned, especially the Bangladesh Navy, have prepared this Bhashan Char for rehabilitation of at least 1 lakh Rohingyas. So it is located in the estuary of Meghna River, Bay of Bengal. So basically, it basically falls in an ecologically fragile area prone to floods, erosion, and cyclone. Now let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to one-horned rhino. First, it has been placed under vulnerable species as per IUCN classification. Second, it is confined only to the state of Assam. So we have to choose that which of the above statements are correct. Let me tell you friends that only one statement is correct, and that is first statement. So it is vulnerable, but it is not just confined to Assam, but also it is seen in Bengal, West Bengal, and then some other northeast states also. So earlier it was found all over the Gangetic. Indo-Gangetic plains. So basically its preferred habitat is alluvial flood plains and areas containing tall grassland along the foothills of the Himalayas. So they were earlier extensively distributed in Gangetic plains, but now they are restricted to small habitats, isolated habitats in Indo-Nepal terrain and North Bengal and Assam. So in India, rhinos are found in Kaziranga, Orang, Pobitara, Jaldarpara and Dudhwa. Now let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to green crackers. First, the green crackers will be able to eliminate 33-35% of the emission of the particulate matter. Second, the manufacturing license for green crackers is issued by the Petroleum and Explosives Safety Organization. So we have to choose that which of the above statements are correct. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. Yes, they are green crackers. It is claimed that they eliminate 33-35% of the emission of particulate matter, and also manufacturing license is provided by Petroleum and Explosives Safety Organization. Solution is C. So they are less harmful and less dangerous than the conventional ones, and they have reduced emission and decibel levels. So they are known as, that's why, green firecrackers. So they have a chemical formulation that produces water molecules. So what these water molecules help in? They help in trapping the dust, and they reduce substantially the emission levels as well as they absorb the dust. So it promises a reduction in particulate matter and harmful gases like nitrous oxide and sulfur oxide by 30-35%. So the green crackers will be 25-30% cheaper to the manufacturer, and manufacturers would not have to make any changes in their facilities. So this was your ninth question. Let's move to the last question of the day. That is, thylacine seen in news is related to A. Enzyme, B. Medicine, C. Tiger, D. None of the above. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is C. Tiger. So basically, it popularly known as Tasmanian tiger. So it is a large striped carnivore. So it is in news because it was believed to have gone extinct over 80 years ago. So, but newly released Australian government documents show that sightings have been reported as recently as 2 months ago. So you can see it has powerful jaws with about 46 teeth, and then yellowish brown to grey fur. So 15 to 20 dark stripes across its back, shoulders, and trail, and then the short legs are there. Stiff tail is there with relatively short legs. So this is all about, friends, today's discussion about daily current affair MCQs. So if you like this discussion, if you like the video, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And lastly, if you have any doubts, queries, you can contact us at this given mail ID, or you can also contact us at given contact number, that is 8968920720. So friends, lastly, we also have a big Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen, and this link will also be provided in the description box. So in this Telegram channel, we have more than 14,000 subscribers that are following us. So if you are interested to get access to various initiatives that are run by us and want to get access to various public resources that we have shared with the students for the purpose of CSE preparation, then do ensure that you check the description box and join this Telegram channel. So basically, if you don't know what this Telegram channel is all about, basically you have to install the Telegram app from the Play Store, and then you can install that app, and installing that app, then you will be you will, obviously your account will be made, and you will have to just search or fill the link in your search box in that account, so you will get access to our channel. So this is all about today's video, friends, and also last request again I'm making is please do motivate us, and please resist from comments that will not be in any case responded by us, because we simply what we will do, we will remove them. So this is the first and last time I'm saying this thing will not be mentioned again on this channel. So be responsible. If you're preparing for civils, then do behave like a serious aspirant. So because tomorrow you have to, in the days coming, you have to run the country. So irresponsibility is not what is expected from you people. So this is all about today's video. Thank you. Have a very nice day ahead.